For this piece, we've created a special base that allows us to remove it directly from the wheel. You can see how we made it in the previous video. First, portion the clay, shape it into a ball and put it on the base. Then, center it using an upward and then downward motion. Then open the center. Now let's move on to the throwing process. Even if the vase we want to create has a round design, we'll start by forming a cylinder. It's important to use the right amount of clay and make your cylinder as symmetrical as possible. Once it's finished, you can create any shape you want. To make a round piece, start by using a downward motion like this. Then, transition to an upward motion by gently pressing the side. Use one hand on the inside and the other on the outside to control the pressure. Then, if you want to create a specific shape of vase or a series like we did here, you can measure it. If it's too big, but you have the shape and the thickness you want, simply remove some clay. For this, use a cutting tool. This process is called trimming. Since the wheel is moving quickly, the clay can be cut easily and precisely. Here, we'll show you how to correct a mistake. As you can see, the potter quickly removed his hands and stopped the wheel when he saw the mistake. After that, the potter can start the wheel again to recreate the vase's shape. We normally use a wire to cut it from the base. But this piece is pre-cut, which allows it to be easily removed later. Since this piece is very fragile, we'll leave it on the base for a while. In the second part of this tutorial, we're going to create the top of the vase we made before. The technique is quite similar. The only difference is that we're not going to form the clay into a cylinder for the first step. Portion the appropriate amount of clay and put it on the wheel. First, we have to center the clay. Then, open the clay. Always wet your hands to be more precise and remove any excess clay. This shape will be unique because we're creating a relief so that the top fits perfectly on the vase. Use a tool to correctly shape the piece. It has to be very accurate. Here, we're using the same T-shaped sticks from before. As you can see, the long part is for the bottom and the small part is for the top. The length remains the same, but we will measure it from the relief, not from the border size. Since this piece is very fragile, we'll leave it on the base. Next, we're going to fire both pieces to get our finished vase.